us.
Yeah, that's true.
Welcome everybody to the Tri-Sinus Podcast. My name is Aves, and check out my beautiful socks for the flash.
They're so fast. Slow down.
You guys see it? I'm sorry,
Ezra Miller.
It's my coworker. She gave it to me. I had to show it to you.
Thanks, Maggie. You're
thanks,
cool.
Thanks
Maggie.
For ruining my
Maggie
mic.
Gets cooler every episode.
Does the socks make you run fast?
Yeah.
No.
Okay.
Anyways, joining me is Sarosh. What's going on, man?
Whoop.
I'm good, bro. I'm good.
You good, bro?
Living the life. Transcendence Podcast.
Yeah, boy.
Here we go.
Here we go. And of course, joining us, our third guy. His name is Kareem's Dreams, Beams, Schemes, Teams.
Fiends.
Leans.
Eat your lima beans.
Damn. These beats so fresh.
Bars. This screen is green.
Fiends. Fiends.
Your shirt's gonna get edited, man.
Deans?
Don't say this, man.
God damn it. I'm gonna take off your shirt.
Right now.
And you know.
Oh, yeah, just saying it.
I should
keep it on. It's a green shirt.
It's green. It's still green.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back after the break where we made our special guest change his hoodie because it was green and was going to blend in with the background. What's going on, Abid?
Nothing much, man. I'm blonde now.
Yeah, I just realized what happened to you.
I don't know, man. Like a phase just happened.
Last it's more than a phase. What happened to your hair? It's yo, like all over the
magic,
place.
Man. He's got the magic.
I got that ever since I saw Fantastic Beast. Like the whole thing is getting on me.
Yeah, man.
Bought the coat, bought the shoes, bought the box, bought
this
the
guy's got the magic.
And then the haircut.
Oh yeah.
But his hair wasn't blonde though. Like why is your hair like blonde?
Oh, like I'm brown, so if I do that type of hair, it'll look kind of weird.
So. Okay,
trying to get as white
so,
as possible.
So you gotta get your British accent too, you know? They're not dangerous.
Oi, love.
They're not dangerous.
Is
that the only thing you know how to say?
That's it.
Okay, cool.
No,
ladies and gentlemen, this
Lisa,
is...
Lisa, can I have some more?
Tea? Can I have
are
samosa?
Please.
Okay. You guys done?
That's it.
You guys done?
Yeah.
You guys done? Okay, okay. Yeah. Guys, this is the Transcendence Podcast where we keep interrupting each other with a useless British accent. You can check us out and our stupid accents along with Abid's blonde hair over at YouTube on the channel Project Pandemonium. That's Panda.
Like the bear.
Like the bear monium. And if you want to check us out on our audio platforms, we are available on SoundCloud, iTunes, Google Music. Who has the first topic? Actually, before we begin, I just want to say happy birthday to our number one listener.
Happy
Ali
birthday
Asrar.
To you.
Happy birthday, man. We love you.
Happy birthday to you.
Are you going to sing the third thing?
I'll just happy birthday, man.
Ali Asrar.
Happy birthday to you.
Are you what?
No, please don't.
No.
Happy birthday, man. Thanks for listening.
Yeah, man. We love you. We love you, of course. And also what is also X, I can't even form sentences. What's X. The first topic, Sarosh?
The first topic today is that we finally got a question from Twitter.
Yes!
Can you believe it, guys?
Is this the first time?
It's from our second listener. It's from our second listener.
After a while, we finally got our first question on the Transcendence Podcast.
Ooh.
And it's by the lovely Zinnia. Who says, can a lightsaber cut through adamantium?
What the? You can't say that. We just saw Logan. And you can't
sorry,
say
that. As soon as I said it, I got some messages popping up. So that threw me off.
Too popular thing. For this show, man.
Yeah.
But, can a lightsaber cut adamantium?
Yeah. But first of all, great question, since it blends in two universes.
Mm-hmm.
And I know Kareem is a big fan of blending two universes.
Oh, yes. So thank you, Zinnia.
Yeah. We just opened a can of worms that I don't think we can ever close, right?
Oh, yeah.
Kareem? Yeah.
Get comfy. I got a lot to say about this.
All right, guys. I'm going to get a pillow.
It's been a very popular question
it is
over
a good
the
question.
Last few weeks.
Yeah.
It's a good question, yeah.
Right.
It's
yeah,
a good question,
over
man.
The media. So
yeah. Questions like this are so much fun to answer. Let me preface this. Open this. This is entirely fictional physics, okay?
100%.
So we're going to discuss and answer some questions, but don't take this too seriously. This is fictional physics. I'm gonna try to use some fictional science,
yeah.
You know, to ground the answer in a realm that suits it. But things like this, they're open-ended. It's mashup universes.
So lightsaber is life.
So basically, nothing is true, everything is permitted.
Ooh,
that Assassin's Creed reference.
I got it, bro.
Yeah. Okay. So
I got it. I got it. Yeah.
So this beautiful question blends two universes together. And one of them happens to be my life, which is Star Wars.
So, how about we actually compare how strong is a lightsaber beam? Like, how much can it cut?
Okay, so I'm going to break down the strengths of each element, and then I'll compare the two. All right?
Okay, go ahead.
I've been waiting for this all day. He's been waiting for someone to ask him.
He didn't go to work today.
I did. Showing up is half the battle.
Good.
Yeah. Adamantium and lightsabers are the rest.
Nice.
So check this out. Being a Star Wars fan, being one with the Force and having the Force with me, my gut reaction is lightsaber has to win. All right? That was my initial reaction.
Okay.
However, I've done some careful research and now I have a more informed opinion.
Okay. Right?
So first I'll break down what a lightsaber is and what adamantium is.
Okay.
So we'll start with our boy over here, Logan, and adamantium.
Well, all of them are actually Logan's, but okay.
Yeah, so he's got the bone claws over here anyways.
Yeah, he's got the bone claws.
Adamantium, it's a metal alloy. So an alloy is a blend of two metals.
Okay.
Right? Now it exists in a liquid state.
Okay.
In the movies, we see it in a liquid state at the Weapon X, Alkali Lake. Right?
Yeah.
So it's not just a metal, but it's a class of metals. It's a class of alloys where the two metals are mixed together, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's an alloy. Now we can compare it to vibranium.
Exactly, because that was going to be my thing, because vibranium is supposed to be stronger than adamantium.
Than anything on Earth, yeah. So similar to vibranium, adamantium has the quality of absorbing all vibration and absorbing all residual kinetic energy. So it can absorb vibrations and kinetic energy.
Exactly. Right? Thus, an example for that is like Thor's hammer.
Exactly, yeah.
Against the Captain America.
Yeah, exactly.
Shield. So, quick question. So can it cut through Cap's shield?
Same answer. Same answer will apply. And I'm going to talk about states of matter here. All right? We're talking about states of matter. So the unit of measurement to measure the resistance of vibranium, again, fictional science, is 1 million Kelvin. Okay?
Okay.
That's the boiling point of adamantium.
Damn.
Yeah.
Right?
That's way too hot, man.
That's
it's hot.
So
way too hot than me, man.
Yeah, it's hot. It's hot in here, man.
Hotter than me.
Just a little bit, eh?
Just a little bit.
It's close. A little bit,
it's close.
Yeah.
It's
close.
It's the blonde hair.
So adamantium can resist up to 1 million Kelvin, which is the equivalent of one solar corona. A solar corona, right?
Yeah,
so imagine like the energy of a sun is what adamantium can resist.
Yes.
All right? So just keep that in your mind right there. It's a metal alloy. It exists. It has to be fused as liquid to shape it. Once it's solid, it's indestructible.
Oh, damn.
Up to one solar corona. Now we're going to move on to sabers, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So sabers are plasma, all right? It's a plasma heat, right? Uh-huh. Like a plasma beam. That's one part. The second part of a saber is the containment field. All right?
Okay.
So, like, you look at Kylo Ren's saber, it's a little bit unstable. Right?
Yeah.
So he has a very weak containment field. The Kyber crystal creates the containment field for that plasma.
Okay.
Because without that containment field, the plasma would just be unhinged, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they do generate heat, but the containment field keeps it contained, right?
Makes sense.
Yeah.
And the unit of measurement for the heat signature of a plasma blade is only 28,000 Kelvin, which is much lower than a solar corona, right?
Damn.
So if you want to go pound for pound, vibranium can absorb more energy than a plasma blade, than a lightsaber per se.
Absolutely. Right?
Now there are different types of lightsabers. There's a Kyber saber, which is like the equivalent of a Death Star beam. So we're going to leave those aside though. All right. So now we're going to go into movie examples of lightsabers and actions.
Mm-hmm.
So the first image that pops into my head when I think of a lightsaber versus metal is in The Phantom Menace. You know, you got Qui-Gon Jinn running around the Trade Federation ship. There's a door that closes and he sticks his saber into the door.
Yeah.
And it heats up the door. It starts melting the door. All right?
Yes.
So it's hot.
Exactly. It generates heat.
Generates heat.
So a lightsaber can melt metal, all right? Much like vibranium can be melted, right? So if a lightsaber were to meet vibranium, if the saber was Intensive.
We're talking about adamantium, right?
Sorry, adamantium. Okay. Yes. I'm sort of equating the two. Maybe that's not a fair assumption to make.
Yeah, because yeah, I think vibranium is stronger.
Stronger?
Yeah, it's stronger. Sure. It's because they can, like, because in the comics, they have an issue where it's like Captain America versus Wolverine and stuff, and he's able to, because his claws can cut through his shield.
So that's why. This brings me to a good point that I should have prefaced it with. These types of answers depend on entirely who wrote the comics that day.
Yes.
Depends on who you ask.
Absolutely.
I'm sure there's one issue where vibranium can be bent by Magneto. Like in the movies, Magneto's bending vibranium.
Yeah.
And in other issues, it's indestructible,
He can. Yeah.
So it's a flavor, it really makes sense.
Yeah.
So, for example, lightsabers. In the movies and in the books, there are lots of substances that can resist lightsabers. One being cortosis. Cortosis is from Darth Bane's novels. It's a metal alloy. Again, they're mining it. They use it for shields, on body armor, for the hulls of ships. Mm-hmm. Cortosis can defend against a lightsaber. Even in the Clone Wars, there's other plasma blades that defend against lightsabers. Again, back in Darth Bane, he's covered with parasites called Orbalisks. And they have shells that are strong enough to repel lightsabers. So there are many examples of substances resisting the blade of a lightsaber. All right, and I would put adamantium and vibranium in that same category. So there are metals that can repel lightsabers. Okay. All right, so right now I haven't really chosen a winner. I've shown the strengths and weaknesses of both.
Okay.
And in true pacifist fashion, I'm gonna make them equal. And here's the catch. Going back to what I said at the beginning, adamantium can become a liquid, right? So let's say a saber is meeting adamantium and it melts the adamantium. The adamantium will become a liquid, the saber will pass through it, and once the saber has passed through, the adamantium will reform into a solid, right?
Yeah, so it's like if it's a claw's gonna cut, the claw is still going to be severed. It's not going to be attached to one thing.
Yeah, that's
it's
basically, the question. Will it cut through?
Can it cut through? Well, like, so cut. So even if it melts it,
it is good.
It could be reformed. Like, you know how a lightsaber cauterizes the wound? It burns it shut.
So if you have an adamantium,
it depends on how they impact. Depends on the surface area. If you have an adamantium wall, and you put a saber, you can make a hole in it. And then you pull the saber out, the hole will just seal itself back up.
Unless if it's like a claw, like this, if this is a claw, and if it cuts it, this part is gonna fall off.
Yeah, so it depends on the point of impact.
Yeah, but it's kind of like the claw, right? It's a claw.
Put more out.
They don't regenerate, do they? Do adamantium?
I don't think adamantium regenerates.
It doesn't regenerate. No.
We're talking over here. It just going through it. So, like, is a lightsaber hot enough to go through the claws in one stroke?
I'm saying no.
Yeah.
Based on Orbalisks and Cortosis and other plasma blades. Because we have three examples of substances resisting lightsabers. So I'm going to give this one to adamantium.
Adamantium? Okay.
Yeah.
Makes sense. So if you put the two together at the same speed going through each other, nothing would happen to either.
Now, but I'm not saying that adamantium could break a lightsaber blade.
No, we're talking about the beam. Yeah. Like, can the beam cut through the claws?
I'm going to say no.
No?
No, yeah.
I think
it would generate a lot of heat.
I think it can, because just how you put it, that, you know... Okay, is it fine?
Yeah.
Just how you put it, that, you know how, like, if there was a adamantium door and you put a lightsaber in, it would go in. So, in a way, it is cutting through in. So, that was the question. Can it cut through adamantium? Yeah.
If it's a
why are you having a hard time saying it's adamantium?
Adamantium.
We watched Logan yesterday. Please, sir.
I'm sorry. I'm just struggling with words.
Apologize to you, Jackman.
I'm sorry, you Jackman. Please come back. Make another Logan. I love you. But but yeah. So the point is that it is cutting through. So I feel like that should be the end of discussion. If it cuts through.
If it's a thin enough surface.
Another reason why I think it can cut through is this whole X-Men universe and this whole like Marvel universe, it's based on like Earth physics. You know what I mean? To explore the whole Star Wars scientific physics,
yes,
that's way more broader and way more, I'm assuming, more powerful than...
Yeah,
than the Earth-like.
Except he still chose adamantium.
Yeah,
he still thought that was like stronger.
So, yeah, I'm glad how you mentioned Earth-based physics because all elements on Earth, right? You know, we can say atoms came from the sun, nova explosions.
That's what I'm trying to say.
So the density of matter on a planet is dependent upon the solar power of its origin, of its sun, right? Mm-hmm. Like all the elements that exist on Earth are as a result of what's in our solar system, right? So if adamantium is from Earth and it's based on our solar sun, like that's power, then it wouldn't be able to be any stronger than an element from outside its galaxy that came from a stronger solar source, right?
It wouldn't be? Or how do we know it wouldn't? Because
so then we have to,
it's a galaxy far, far away.
Yeah.
Long time ago.
So Kyber crystals, yeah.
It's kind of weird,
so
right?
It's hard like to measure their energy. That's what I'm trying to say.
I would say adamantium will trump an Earth-based kyber crystal saber.
Okay.
Because you have to make a fair playing field.
Yeah.
So the saber has to come from Earth too. Right?
But has there ever been a saber that came from Earth?
Well, no.
that's what I'm trying to say.
Okay, how about we compare it to vibranium? Yeah, because vibranium is not from Earth.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not. It's from like outside.
Wakanda.
Right?
So Wakanda.
Fuck, I forgot. No,
we both screwed up.
Whoa, wait.
Black Panther.
Yeah, the Cap's shield.
No, I'm. What was that material that comes from another meteor or something? What was that
thing? Used in what?
In the Marvel Universe.
The Black Rock in the Holy Kaaba? That's a meteorite.
Doesn't ring a bell, man. Like,
okay, whatever.
In the Marvel Universe? But like, what Marvel Universe?
Okay, never mind. I'm just going to cut everything out.
Okay.
But like, we know for a fact that vibranium is the strongest metal in the Marvel Universe. So
yeah. So now, to answer Abed's question, can a lightsaber cut through Cap's shield?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna still go with no.
No, eh?
Based on no. Yeah.
It can hard cut
if,
through.
I guess it's gonna left through, left be there for like a long time.
Yes,
something.
Exactly.
But we're talking like just like
Like swipe,
like a quick swipe, like you would with a lightsaber.
Ah, you know what? You reminded me of something. Check this out. I'm gonna go back to physics. Force equals mass times acceleration. Right?
Okay.
Force equals mass times acceleration. You can't change the mass of an object.
Okay, right? But
you can change the acceleration.
Sure.
So acceleration is change in speed over time.
So faster swipe
will make a stronger force.
Yes. Right? So like. Are you saying that if you swing a lightsaber fast enough,
you could
cut through the claw?
But
can you say the same thing about the claws then? Can they cut through
a saber?
Yeah.
So sabers can be weaker. Like the intensity of a saber blade depends. Like there's sabers in Clone Wars that are weak, you know?
And then here's my follow-up question, okay? Because if Wolverine swings his claws or something like really fast towards a saber, are his claws gonna get cut or is the sabers gonna go like cut? So that leads to the same thing you're saying, like sabers are both weak and strong. So which one is it then?
So check this out, it's an inconsistency. Yeah. In Rebels, Ezra and Kanan are training and they can adjust the intensity of their sabers. They lower it to make it a training saber.
I use the force to make it stronger or weaker. Or
you can,
like that.
Yeah, and that's
you can use the force to put more force into it, right? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Well, what I'm saying there is, like, if Wolverine goes at you and you have a lightsaber, I just think it'll go through like a laser, like laser beam, like the thing, right? That's what's gonna happen. It's not gonna cut through it. If it's left there for a long period of time, it'll melt. But if we're just talking like a quick swipe, it's not gonna cut through it.
Yeah. There's so many factors to consider.
The 1,000 degree knife challenge. Lightsaber challenge.
Okay, so what are the temperature of Wolverine's claws in this
it's
fight?
Back. Right? What cuts through Wolverine's claws?
Yeah.
That's the real question. Mm.
And so what vibranium and adamantium do is they can dissipate energy, right? By reducing the acceleration of an object. So they can slow it down. Like, you know when Thor hits Cap's shield?
So if there's playing like fast enough, it's not gonna stop the intensity. It's going to slow it down. Yeah. Is that what you mean? Okay.
Yeah.
Interesting. Interesting. Yeah. So how about we kind of like just take our picks right here? Who's on whose side? Like, is it the saber or the claws?
Lightsaber is life, so lightsaber. Go for
claws.
Lightsaber, bro.
The claws.
I'm one with the force, and the force is with me. And vibranium, and adamantium can overpower lightsabers.
Damn. That's a big thing coming from it Kareem is. Right now.
Yeah, that's a big thing.
I'm being subjective right now.
I'm gonna go with the claws too. I think you're alone on this one.
But if you look at it, like in the whole X-Men,
could have balanced it up, but no, screw you guys.
Because
of the movie Logan, isn't it?
No,
because like the Logan high.
Maybe
Obi-Wan would kick Logan's ass.
Yo, shut the hell up, okay? I'm gonna kick your ass.
I'm joking. I love
Logan. We have three Wolverines here and a.
I love you, Logan.
I was just.
I have to take some notes.
I just have to say that.
You know,
I stab him now.
I'm sorry, bro.
I was just gonna say that, like, the question has to do with cutting.
Mm-hmm.
It's not gonna cut right away. Hob is right. It's not gonna cut.
It's gonna has to be there for a long period of time.
It's gonna block it. Of course, it's going to cut it eventually, but it's not gonna cut like right away.
At the end
of the
day, eventually, it will cut through.
But what were we main smart? Point we'll just cut through. The hat off.
Yo, he can legit just like kick them back. The longest time
situation,
is gonna
then that's
take
like
the longest
topic.
Time. It's gonna yeah. take but the like, longest time.
Wolverine
to
is smart too. We'll just cut the hand off and bang, no more lightsaber action.
No, but his thing is right too. Like it's like I don't know, man. I'm not sure how strong or the intensity of the lightsaber is, but. I know more about the adamantium stuff, so I'm going to take that side.
Yeah, so the intensity of a saber is inconsistent, and there are several examples of lightsabers not being able to penetrate certain substances. Sorosh would know this if he had watched Clone Wars and Rebels, just saying.
I'll watch it, man, jeez. Okay, let me paint a situation for you and tell me who would win in this fight, okay? Obi-Wan versus Logan.
Okay.
In the deserts of
old
Tatooine.
One or like...
Like Prime Obi-Wan versus Prime Logan.
You're talking about like General Kenobi or Crazy Old Ben?
No, Prime...
Like General Kenobi from the Clone Wars?
Yeah, so like Obi-Wan at his prime.
That's a good fight.
Logan at his prime.
More, he has more...
At, like... In Tatooine. So Obi-Wan got home court advantage.
Why does he need home court advantage?
I'm just saying.
He can just
you guys,
use
we had
the force
three.
And then just
we had
like,
three for.
Rodent. I mean, in order to kill Wolverine, you'd have to dismember him.
We had three
and separate
against one.
His limbs.
He can easily.
But
he
let's,
can. Like, it's...
let's. So I gave you that situation. Who would win in that fight? Wolverine. In that situation.
All right, I'm gonna play this game. I'm gonna put Wolverine on a sandworm. On Tatooine.
No,
right?
It's just a desert. It's a plain desert Tatooine.
And worms live in the desert. Sandworms live in the desert. It's part of the desert.
I'm picking Wolverine, man.
Just tell me who'll win, Logan or Obi-Wan.
No,
I want to paint a nicer picture. I'm telling a story here, right?
Go ahead.
So Logan is riding a sandworm.
Oh, come on.
Rising and cresting through the desert.
Okay,
the sun is shining behind him like that awesome Logan
claws,
monster.
Just like this.
That means
like this, going up and down.
He's got Kaleo playing
it's
in his tunes. Way down.
Shine bouncing off.
It's Hugh Jackman. Hugh Jackman with his shirt up.
Way down we go.
Oh, yeah.
But he's riding the thing.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, what's next?
The Shun beaming off his claws
and
just blending everything.
And Kenobi's just chilling, making tea. You know, he's doing nothing. He's reading his books, looking out for Luke, doing God knows what.
Well, can't Kenobi just do this?
Yeah, yeah. So like, hey, here you go.
Yeah.
Alright, so Logan flies back. Logan doesn't stop. He just keeps coming.
That's true.
If he wants to go away, he's going to like, oh man, this is a waste of time. I'm going to get in my thing and then just leave Tatooine.
Just throw him in space. He's like, okay.
Hey man, Logan is a hunter. He will sniff you and he will find you. You can't run from Logan. He's a hunter, man.
Actually,
an animal.
That's a good point. Logan would win in that aspect. He's more...
He's got the rage.
Yeah.
Yo, think about
it. He has the instincts.
Obi is defensive and passive.
Yeah,
you know,
he would always find a way to be. You are good. I must save you, but he doesn't give a crap. Wolverine doesn't give a crap. He's gonna kill him.
There's only one way to find out, and that's like you know those IGN people that do the videos, like Batman vs. Darth Vader.
Yeah,
have you guys seen those videos?
So good.
they need to do this.
Okay. It was
Obi-Wan
so good.
Versus Logan.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
And let's see.
That'll
who
be
wins.
A good fight, actually.
And other factors will come into play, like sandworms. The sobriety of
But yeah, Wolverine has a good like field and well, not field advantage, but he's a you rub a very good point. He's a
he's a hunter.
Well, yeah. If you think about it, he regenerates.
So. Yeah, yeah. He has the instincts.
And like enough respect to Obi-Wan. I love the Clone Wars. General Kenobi, you're a homie, man. He's a G.
And it's more like, you know, the more angry Wolverine gets, too, the
I like how you mentioned Obi-Wan like he was like a real person. That you get right.
Kenobi,
if you're watching. If you're watching right now.
Kenobi, I can feel you. I got you up here, man.
God damn it.
I got Logan right here, though.
All right, guys.
Yeah. Oh, there you go.
See, Zenya,
you got Logan there.
These are the types of questions we like, because it just sends a spiraling, man.
Oh, yeah, man. Jesus. That was a great question. That was a great question. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Zenya.
So there's a podcast I listen to where they do weekly mashups, and they put characters versus each other, usually from the same universe. And they sort of tell stories like D&D style of, you know,
fight. Well, let's do it then.
It's so much fun, yeah.
I think we should start one too.
Oh, yeah. Weekly battles.
We should try that, yeah. That'd be pretty cool.
I'll try to go against you every time, okay? So
what a surprise!
I know. Always is better. All right. The next topic comes from our guest, Abid. What's up, man?
So, like, now we're gonna go away from the whole comic and stuff. We're gonna jump into the gaming stuff.
Ooh. Damn.
So, let me ask you guys. So, when you guys were kids, right? When you guys went to go play games, like, what did you, like, look forward to? Like, what made you, like, damn, that's something new? Like, when I was a kid, like, when I saw animation, like, it was the X-Men game, actually.
Yeah.
It was on the PlayStation 1, and it was, like, a fighting type of, like, Street Fighter type of game.
Absolutely.
So that's the one I started with, and I was like, that is so cool. And over the years, I've seen gaming just, like, progress to a whole new level.
Yeah.
And now, like, being virtual reality, the way you can actually be in the game and do stuff, which is pretty insane, because I tried it, and it's like, you're, like, in the whole new different world, basically. What do you guys think is the future of gaming in 10 years? Like, will we see this
in 10 years?
Yeah, like, would you think this will go more intense or
the next step in evolution?
My ultimate dream would be like where you can actually like jump into the game and do the whole thing by yourself, where you're actually in the game and immersed. You feel for it, like the Assassin's Creed type of thing. Where you jump into it.
What's that machine called that they're in?
VR?
Animus. Yeah.
So pretty much like you go under it and you have full control over everything. That'd be pretty cool.
So would you volunteer to get plugged into the Matrix?
No, not like that.
Oh, yeah.
Not like that.
So, hell yeah.
Okay.
And then I record a podcast inside the Matrix. This is a waste of time, right? This is a waste of time.
They don't listen to it in real life. They won't listen in the Matrix.
Okay, Sarosh. Can you be a little more supportive, please?
I'm sorry. I love you trashing a podcast for life.
Maybe that's...
But to answer...
My co-host for the past 30 episodes and he's like shitting on me. What the hell?
Okay, but to answer Abid's question, so what I always look for in games were the graphics. You know, if the graphics can hook you, you know, and then that was like the number one thing. If the graphics are good, then gameplay came after, and then story and all that stuff, that came after for me.
Makes sense.
So I feel like in the future, this whole VR technology that we have right now, as soon as the graphics become lifelike and like top notch, that's a game changer right there, man. That's like the whole new experience, whole new level.
And just to add to that, you know, like I've noticed the VR stuff, it's not as great as you would play on the screen.
Now, it's going to be good in 10 years, though.
Oh, definitely. If you think about it, like, when you look 10 years ago, like, what PlayStation V had, like, compared to that to PlayStation 4.
Yeah, it was, like the weird, like...
It was PlayStation 2 or PlayStation 3 even, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, look at that and now look at what we have now. Cause
absolutely,
because recently I'm playing Horizon and the game is just incredibly, like, it just looks beautiful.
Yeah.
And that's definitely, like, another graphics-wise, right? That's, like, another top-notch game that's been doing so well.
Yeah, that's true. Like, nowadays, like, I feel like developers make so much effort into making their game look nice, where like I think you're right, and that's what really hooks you. If the game looks good, you would definitely be more in tune to like, you know, picking it up.
Yeah. I think there's more of a focus now, like you both said, I'm on graphics
and the 100%. And the realism. That's like a main thing right now.
Yeah,
I'm a little bit old school, man. I care more about story. Like I grew up playing Street Fighter on SNES. Yeah.
How's this? What?
Like 16-bit.
Story?
Sorry.
What is the story?
Oh, there's a story. Oh, yeah. You want me to go there? I'll go there.
Round one.
Wait.
The round two. Story. Huh? Oh, yeah. Final round.
There, huh? No. I know there's a story. I know there's a story, but at the same time, there were other games with stories.
Yeah.
Like that's Zelda and all this.
Oh, yeah, Zelda.
Perfect. Yeah, Mario. Yeah. Like, Mario. What was the story of Mario?
You find the peach, man. Peach.
Princess, you're like.
You find the forbidden fruit. Okay, but anyways, the thing was that.
What?
No, but yeah, like, I kind of agree with
so
you.
So I identified with Ryu a lot. When you beat the game with Ryu,
yeah.
And they have the podium, you know, first, second, third place.
Yes.
You got Sagat and Bison at second and third. And the first place is empty because Ryu doesn't even show up for the medal ceremony.
Okay.
And you just see him walking off into the desert, all Logan style.
Yeah.
Solo, lone wolf. And he says, you know, the victory doesn't matter. All that matters is the fight. You know, and that's just like a moral code that
that's so sick.
It's like two lines of dialogue, and I'm like, okay, that's my dude. Like Batman and Ryu, they're like loners, but all they care about is like the moral victories. They don't care about all this physical, superficial stuff like graphics and all that, you know? 16-bit justice.
Just shout out, boy, you guys.
Man,
I'm just gonna say,
I'm the oddball.
I was gonna add, okay? This goes back to the same thing that we talked about, that being happy with something isn't the result, it's the process. And he likes to fight. And that is what matters for him the most. It's not being first. He knows that, man. He knows that.
It's just like this award season that just passed by for the Oscars. You know?
What a segue.
It's the journey.
What a segue.
The journey, not the destination.
Yeah, it doesn't matter who wins, La La Land or Moonlight.
Yeah,
it's just a good movies. Both are good movies.
I'm not even sure who won because I didn't watch the Oscars. I'm going to watch both movies.
That was awkward as shit, though, man.
Oh, talking about Oscars, you guys know who won Best Hair and Makeup?
I think I'll give you Best Hair.
DC it was Suleiman. I barf every time I say that movie's name. Suleiman.
How come even DD fanboys are upset that Suicide Squad won an Oscar?
It didn't deserve it.
Abed and I get along great because we're DC fanboys, you know, till death.
To be honest, it didn't deserve it. First of all, have you seen Star Trek's makeup in that movie?
Yeah.
In Beyond? They had like everything going.
New alien species. Why?
But so, Suicide Squad, because Harley Quinn had like the good lipstick on it.
That's because she's hot, bro.
She's hot, man.
She's hot.
The Academy that chooses who wins and loses, they're just people just like us. It's just a bunch of opinions of a bunch of rich elitists, you know?
It's
just other opinions.
Old...
Yeah. You know? And so I don't like it when society gathers around the views of a few. Go make up your own mind, you know?
Man. Go make up your own mind. Okay.
I was going to say
your
own mind.
Don't do
edit.
That.
Make up your own damn mind, you know? Think for yourself.
Is that legal?
I agree, man. Huh?
Is it legal to make your own man? What is this, Westworld?
Frankenstein, man.
There's a plug.
There Westworld is a good plug right there, man.
Make a man and then give him the power to make up his own mind.
It's a very good show.
It's a really good show, but the most trippiest show ever. I'm on episode 5 and I still don't know what's going on.
Oh, bro, the last episode? Holy.
Yeah.
I'm getting one of the best season finales of all time, man, I thought. But yes, come back to that. I do agree with you 100%. I played Crash Bandicoot. I love the story of that game, man. Okay, to me...
There's a story in that game?
Exactly, bro. come back to like Final Fantasy VII. That game is long, but the story is deep, man. It's really good. Yeah, because to me, when I used to look for games, yes, graphics were important for me, but the most important thing for me was gameplay and then story.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Gameplay is, if it's entertaining and engaging, it is the best thing I do. Like, Spider-Man 2, the movie, the game, that was the name of the movie.
Oh, God.
It was such a good game.
Graphically, that game was like nothing, but it was fun to play.
It was so fun to play because you could do anything. You could speed up your swing. You could tie people using the web to the lamppost.
And this is like when there were like no superhero games.
I know, and it was such a fantastic game.
Yeah, so it kind of reminds me of like mine's called Minecraft.
Yeah,
like,
things, like creativity. Yes, exactly. That's such a good example. Even though, who the hell even plays that game? But like, it's like when and it actually came out and the community just made it into such a big thing because it's nothing. It's building.
It's creativity. Yeah. You know?
You can do whatever you want. Yeah,
I've seen some crazy
open
stuff,
world man. Games. Open yes, world, and one.
I would say like
I like the freedom, man.
Yeah, I would say like we've got to the point in like gaming where I think we don't even have to worry about graphics anymore. Like any game that really comes out these days,
it's so good, right?
The graphically, it's definitely good. The other thing cannot be good: the story, the gameplay,
yeah,
the characters.
So that's the X factor.
Yeah. That's what I think people lack at.
See,
now.
That's what. Just to counter your guys' points, how you guys are saying graph like story was more important, but that was back in the day. You know, you guys are giving examples of games that were
even right
back
now.
In the day.
Even
in
right
terms now, like, of that, in that time, the graphics for that specific game was considered decent or good in that
Tetris
time.
Tetris on Game Boy.
You know
what
I mean? Like, it was really good. Yes.
In that time was good, but like so, but now nowadays you're not gonna play like a 2-bit graphic game with a great story,
dude,
and be like, oh, it's the best game I ever played.
No, man. I am going
graphics.
I'm going to argue with man. Have you heard of the game called Undertale? Undertale is
probably
a PC
reason why
game.
I haven't heard.
Yeah, Undertale is a PC game, and it has 2-bit graphics. Mm-hmm. It's legit a side scroller and choice based game, and then it's like an RPG and stuff, and it is crazy. It's dark, big. Yeah. It hooks you because it's not like any other game, and it's one of the best games from I think 2014, I think, or 15. Yeah.
Well, it's like people have their own
genre. It's crazy.
Like,
yeah.
Like, for me now, like I love role playing games, right? Like I would not go back to it.
Oh yes, I can
like
see.
That.
I can see the whole
role playing. Yeah.
Fantastic. He's looking.
And just comparing the last few games that I played, like obviously, like graphically, they were graphically enhanced, but they were not all of them. But not gameplay wise, they were not that good.
Yeah.
Story modes were different. So, but nowadays, I think that graphics in the games are like 100% If a developer is making the game their first priority to like get the graphics out of the way, they're gonna be good.
Triple A game though. Yes.
Like
exactly.
But like nowadays, the only games that really get attention are the big AAA games, right? Like if you think
absolutely,
about
absolutely,
like, E3, like when they come to E3, the only things they really show is the big games, right? They
absolutely.
Yes, they show the small games.
And all those big games.
That's money, man.
That's money for them, right? Like, and the only big games that really sell over the whole year is the big games. Like,
that's what'll get all the attention.
I'm not saying the small games themselves. Mm. They do, but they get looked over because there's so many games that come out.
And all
absolutely,
those big games
agree,
have like graphics as top of their priority
so, like,
as well.
This Tuesday, Horizon came out, and next week Tuesday we're getting Ghost Recon Wildlands.
Yeah.
So it's like two different games. Yes, like Horizon's a whole
and
different
it's fun,
game.
Yeah.
And like Ghost Recon's a whole different game. So like it's people's choices, man. Like
I agree with that.
And both games, like graphically they're insane. I played the closed beta for Ghost Recon, insane. I'm picking it up, obviously.
Oh yeah,
so,
yeah, for sure.
So, but now I'm in a dilemma on which one I should play first, because
you should just play Horizon.
I think I'm gonna finish Horizon first. Like,
yeah, you should finish
it's
it.
Like 40 hour.
Because Tom Clancy one is good for.
Clancy game, I heard like this is the biggest map Ubisoft has ever made.
Bro, can they fix their servers though?
I know, man.
I know, right?
People can't even get into the
beta.
The game they just released, like For Honor?
For Honor? Yes.
What's happening? Is it too crowded?
No, their servers are really bad. They keep you keep getting like logged out.
Well,
and
they don't have anything like Call of Duty or anything like that, right? Like,
so yeah, they need the Oasis system.
They need the Oasis. Okay, so coming back to that, thank you for bringing us back into track, because Hobbit's main question was that the future. What do you expect to see in
the
next
future? Yeah, for the game.
10 years, right? So now I am going to say that. You saying the Oasis, that is the future, because if anybody knows what the Oasis is,
it ain't this handsome
online
dude.
It ain't me, ladies. It is basically an online world from the book Ready Player One, where it's you log into the world using a visor and like haptic gloves and everything, and then you go to this online world. I'll just look at Sarosa. Sarosa's looking dead at the camera. I'm watching angry. Your soul.
I just don't want you to spoil anything about that book. That's just
I'm not gonna spoil anything. Yeah. Okay, so it's so that is the future. Just being inside a world where you can do whatever the hell you want. You can go to school. Mm-hmm. You can go to freaking play space. Video games. You can go to any planet. All your Star Wars, or your video game universes are there.
So pretty much like the Assassin's Creed animus. Do anything.
Pretty close.
Yeah. No. Want. But yes, but think bigger. Bigger. Think. Oh, yeah, okay. Because you can any game, yeah. any game, any universe pick you can it. Go
just
into.
Pick yeah. one and just
go pick one it. And yeah. go.
That's yeah. crazy.
So first
that,
of all,
that is the future. But that's like, future. I don't think that's gonna happen in the next 10 years. I'm gonna say next 15 years.
So probably. How do you guys feel about that? First yeah. of all, thank you for recommending the book. Yeah. I'm more of a bookworm than a gamer, yeah, and that's a it's a good book. Ready Player One. It's yeah, a great man. Book. It reads fun.
Please
so
pick it up. It's amazing.
Movie coming. Who knows when? Steven Spielberg. It's a great book. And that kind of intense, immersive experience scares me. You know,
really?
I'm more reality based. You know, okay. I already see video game addiction and immersive world and escapism running rampant. Yeah. You know, where the virtual world trumps the real world.
Except think,
I'm trying to get more analog. You know,
but think you're inside Star Wars all the time, man.
In my books, in my own head, in no, my own imagination.
But virtual reality inside.
Why,
yeah,
why not live it? Why not live it, bro?
Here's an open-ended question: okay, what's the difference between your own imagination when you close your eyes and imagine? What's the difference between that and, you know, virtual reality?
I can answer that. It has to do with your five senses being alive. So being in virtual reality, if you can see, if you can feel, if you can like smell.
You're not gonna feel or smell anything.
Oh yes, you will.
Who knows?
I still think the real world has the best graphics.
But but can you see Star Wars in real world?
Right now I can.
You know, pretty good. Are you smelling everything?
Are you in Tatooine smelling?
Yo, my imagination then? Trumps all your 16.
All the worm shit you smell.
But I definitely get what you're saying.
I have lost friends to video games. You know. Ari's, where are you?
You haven't lost me. You haven't lost me.
Thanks for coming out, man.
No problem.
Yeah.
But yes, like I do agree.
That, people like, have practices of, and stuff and like
it's crazy
training.
Yeah. Everybody just gets really into it and then the addiction becomes real and then I really want to know what's Rose thinks because Rose just is quiet the entire time.
About what the
what's the next 10 years, man?
I just like I said earlier in when I answered Abba's question, is just VR experience with better graphics. Which adds to your point, as you know, to have a more realistic experience.
What about the holodeck from Star Trek, you know? Or like Abed's Imaginarium.
That's
which
true.
Was the holodeck.
Which is the holodeck.
That's true. You but know? Would you be in it inside your head or
well, that
you...
that's real. Like, that's like a room. Like the danger room in X-Men. You know how Professor X has the danger room?
Well, yeah, I wouldn't mind that either.
That'd be cooler because that's true, that's real. You're actually moving and running and jumping.
Actually,
you know?
That's basically gaming.
Well,
you're not sitting on a couch eating chips doing nothing. This is exercise. It's a stimulated environment.
Yeah,
I'm not wearing a mask. This is real.
No,
but I think when Waze was explaining it, he meant it like that. Like you get immersed into that world.
So a whole
machine. Like your body machine. Goes all into it. Like
Well, that, but then.
No, your body's here.
So if I want to run and travel in the game world, should I move my legs or I just push A?
No, I want to run. So I'm thinking more from like really advanced. So you have this entire room and it can be like a spiral. Or it's like a hamster ball or something. Or it could be like a treadmill here that moves and stuff.
Like a moving floor. Remember, you see that Jamiroquai video for virtual insanity? Where the floor is moving?
Okay. Yeah. So just like
virtual world insanity.
Plus you have like fans and stuff that stimulate. Like
cheering you on.
Like, the smells and all that stuff. And then if you're running, you have to run, you know, so it's possible, but it's going to be possible in a while.
You know, and like, right now, I probably came off as a little paranoid, fearing technology and stuff.
And now he's embracing it. He's like,
yes,
Star Wars 24/7.
He's going to have his lightsaber and just run around in that danger room. Just go crazy.
Like,
yo, that would be pretty sick, though.
Every time there's a leap in technology, people get scared. When TVs came out, people probably said, oh, we're all gonna become zombies. You know?
Really? Yeah, we did.
We did.
Honestly, I think cell phones make us into zombies. People need to look up when they're walking across the street and stuff, you know?
Yeah, and then I can punch them in the face because they on their phones all the time.
Look at me.
I'm really violent.
So yeah, I say everything in moderation, even moderation.
Absolutely. Yeah, I agree with that.
But good.
I don't know. Yeah, man. That was a good question. That was a very good question, man.
So future of gaming, we shall see.
We shall see. That's always the thing.
If you guys don't find me, you guys probably know I'm like a groom or something.
Find him online.
Inside the Anubis.
Find me online.
Retracing his past.
Where did I go wrong?
I think that all this technology.
Can you imagine? Where you have the choice. I'm sorry, I cut you off. But like, just think, like, you have the ability to go anywhere you want, but you go back to your past and stick.
What happened
to me?
So why did I miss something?
So that's just called like meditation.
That's like time travel, don't you think?
Yeah, kind of. That could be a game.
Is it a game? It's a very depressing game.
It's a very depressing game.
What did I do with my life?
It's psychological therapy, if you think about it, right?
That's smart. I can go back to where I was getting my hair colored. Don't do it!
Like the Flash in the Batman vs. Superman movie. Plug in! You haven't plugged in that for a while.
What? Oh no!
We had a good streak going on! No! Why?
I don't know. I just had to do it.
Dresses every week, man.
I just had to do it.
I'm sorry. Okay. I cut you off.
I don't remember what I was going to say anymore.
God damn it, I'm sorry.
But I have a new idea now.
Like, yes. Whoa, what is it?
I'm going to be traditional here. You know? Okay. I'm going to be the voice of the old school.
Okay.
You want deep immersive reality? Same. You want to travel into your past? You want to explore your ancestral DNA?
Yeah.
Your ancestral memories that are encoded in your DNA?
Yeah. Say it.
Right? You want to experience every sensation in your body?
Just say it.
Oh, preach, bro. Preach.
Yoga. Meditation.
Oh, man.
Okay?
Meditation.
Look up Vipassana meditation. Vipassana is seeing things. Turn that frown upside down. Meditation, yay, man. You know, great. All this external stimulus that we seek, that's because we lack that same stimulus from within.
Yo, I heard you can get lost in that type of stuff, man.
Meditation? Or virtual? Are you more afraid of meditation than gaming?
Actually, I'm like, I don't know. Like, I heard, like, if you do some shit with your brain, it's like.
So you'd rather trust Ubisoft with your brain?
I don't know, man.
Gun violence.
You had such a good thing going on. He's like, you know, you should do this. I heard you can get lost in that. I don't want to do that shit, bro.
I don't want to do that shit, bro. I remember when I was in school and our teacher, we were talking about meditation and stuff, right? He's like, I tried doing it once and I almost got lost. Like, my brain went somewhere. I was like, holy shit.
How do you know he was telling the truth?
I don't know, man.
Could be scary.
You know, this is grade 8, man.
Because of that thing, you're going to just completely reject her.
I heard, but I get what you're trying to say. I definitely get, like,
I love the real world.
I definitely get what you're saying. Like,
oh my God.
There's many people that do that still.
They're not that different. They're both virtual worlds. One we're in control of. The other one is just programmed by some game company that wants to sell guns and violence and blood.
That's true.
You know. Right? So the power of this virtual world, I think, is incredible.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's misused because all it does is promote violence in society.
Yeah.
So let's use all that good virtual immersive technology, like they do in Ready Player One, for education, you know?
Yes.
Jump inside the cells of a plant. Yeah. Look about cytoplasm and photosynthesis.
Man.
Explore the rings of Saturn. Learn.
Explore the cosmos, bro.
Yeah, man.
It's so huge. Like, anybody could just
program
anything. That is something.
Education.
Education would be on another level. Like, because see, think of how much you'll save on, like, field trips and everything, right?
There you go.
Right?
You don't have to buy $100,000 to go to the moon or something.
Exactly.
Yeah, so technology in the classroom is a huge thing. Right now?
Yeah.
Go ahead. You go
first. No. I was just going to say that just like your classes will become so much more interesting, man.
Yeah.
Because you'll just go into anything you want to explore, research, and everything.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, gaming is awesome, but like just at a grander scale, I can see the future being awesome, man.
Yeah.
It's like a tool to help you explore.
Yeah, and how you use that tool.
You use that tool is up to you.
Like, a thing isn't good or bad. Like, how it's used.
Plug in with great responsibility.
Oh, man, I can... I So 10 years later, I'm going to have Saroj just wear the helmet. I'm going to put Batman versus Superman on repeat.
Stop!
I kind of want to...
Like, he's on the ground like, stop!
Transcendence episode.
Martha! No! Stop saying Martha!
Why did you say that?
Who plays Suicide Squad? Suicide Squad?
Smile, Superman, yeah. Smile!
They're both being on...
On loop.
On repeat, on loop.
Oh my god, I would...
Together. Smile, Superman, say hello.
Backwards, backwards.
So I think one of the happiest on-screen Superman moments this decade was probably the Deadpool trailer. You know, when we heard the Superman theme, and we smiled.
Right, man, that was an awesome topic, man.
Yeah, man.
That was pretty good.
Always gets
good job, that was pretty good.
Always imagine the best.
You can see the sadness. Yeah.
He's just transcending into his own.
He just went back to his past. Yes. What did I do wrong?
Yeah, what did I do wrong?
Why did I change my hair
color? Man, I mean, if you want to talk, you can just talk to us, man. You don't just
I'm happy with the decisions I make.
That's good.
I'm joking.
High five.
Yeah, man. You can't change the past. So it's cool. Like, games are used as escapism.
Yeah, man.
I say use yourself for introspection.
Absolutely.
You know, don't run away.
I say, like, games came at the right time in my life to, like, really, you know, help and stuff, that type of thing. So it was like a getaway. So I would say it was a really good thing, and I love it till day. You know, like, that's what really made me into a gamer, and, like, I tell this to right? So
absolutely, man.
Amen, bro. Amen.
Everybody has their thing, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely, man. Moving on to the next topic, and the final topic of the podcast is Kareem's topic.
Ah, yes. Okay. So my topic is not about gaming or sci-fi or Star Wars or comic books or Logan or anything fictional.
Mm-hmm.
I'm back in the real world. Mm-hmm. We're grounded, so this is our real life moment now.
Awesome.
So my topic is open-ended and vague. It's the concept of sacrifice. Every day, every week, every moment we're living, we're sacrificing something for the greater good. Whether we're conscious of it or not, mm-hmm. we're always making choices. Every moment is a choice. We try to make healthy choices.
Absolutely.
But literally, all of our decisions are governed by external factors. You know, we need shelter, food, security, right?
Pretty much your whole day.
Right? So yeah, we're always sacrificing something, right? Yeah. I don't think everyone has the privilege, at least to us, you know, normal folks, don't have the privilege of doing whatever we want. You know, we all dream about winning the lottery. But, you know, from my personal perspective, I've been looking back at my life. I have, you know, like Abed, I look back and I wonder, what can I do 5 years forward, mm-hmm. right? What's my next 5-year plan?
Makes sense.
And so I'm at year 4 of a 5-year plan, mm-hmm. where I said, okay, I'm gonna sacrifice, like, I've changed careers a bunch of time. I was in teaching, I sacrificed my personal time so that I could do my marketing and my lesson planning.
Mm-hmm.
You know, some jobs are stressful, some jobs are not. So we're always making sacrifices for the greater good. And so, at what point do we lose the thing that we're pursuing? You know, like, if I'm sacrificing my time so that I can work to live, to enjoy myself, it seems like at some point we lose that our target. Because, you know, like, people work so they can raise their family, but then they don't have time to see their family, you know? Mm. So we lose what we're chasing because we're sacrificing everything for it, you know? So, I mean, it's a very open-ended question.
So you mean, like, at what point do you stop chasing that or something like that?
And stop making the sacrifices and go after what you want. You know?
Okay, so I can actually go first because, you know, it's a huge time to think as well. I was just going to say that because this happened to me last year because I was always the kind of person who would always do things to make other people happy. And it would take a lot of my time. So just like, if someone was like, hey man, you should come hang out and all that stuff, even though I didn't want to, I would have work or I would have something else, I would still go with them all the time because I didn't want them to think that I'm a loner. You know, everything I did had to do something with me trying to justify my personality to other people.
Yeah, and by their standards.
Exactly, which is wrong in the long run. It's good in the short term because then, you know, if you think your friends think you're cool or your coworker thinks you're great and all that stuff, because, like, sometimes at work in the past, I would kind of, you know, I'm not going to say I would try to oversell myself and the things I did to make my boss happy. Which isn't something that you're supposed to do. You're supposed to be honest, right? You're supposed to just be yourself because they want to see who you are as a person, okay? So anybody who does that at their jobs, it's good at the short term, it's not good for the long term, right?
It'll catch up to you.
Absolutely. Because you can be fake forever, okay? So, and I'm saying last year, because last year I saw that I had all this free time and I put them in places that, you know, are a complete waste of time. Like I used to watch countless videos on YouTube. I used to watch like movies all the time. I used to play games and all that stuff. And I was like, you know what?
Yeah.
I can do something that makes me happy. Like, why am I sacrificing time that to, you know, catch up on shows so I can talk to my coworkers and make them think that, okay, you know what? I'm also part of this thing as well. I don't have to be part of something. Wow, I have to be deep. Just, yeah, I just have to be part of like just what makes me happy, right?
Makes sense.
Yeah.
Do what you want to do.
Treat yourself.
Exactly. Treat yourself.
And on your own terms.
Yes. And that is why I called up Sarosh again. You know, we started a podcast and I started making videos on YouTube and everything, right? Because that is something, just the process actually makes me happy. Yeah. Like just recording, talking in front of a camera and everything like that makes me happy. And that is something I chose to do. Mm-hmm. And now sometimes, you know, Roche wants to hang out and I don't hang out with him. And it's not that I hate him. It's just that I know that sometimes I have to take our time to do these things.
Oh yeah.
Makes sense.
Yeah, it's, why is it so hard for us? I'm speaking generally.
Yeah.
It seems like a lot of people have a hard time taking time for themselves.
Yeah.
We're always bending over backwards for family, friends, bosses, whatever.
That's true.
Exactly. And I just want to end it off, like my thing, by just saying that sometimes all of us need is what's Sarosh refers to as me time.
Mm-hmm.
He says me time.
Definitely.
It's not what you're thinking, you dirty minded people.
Nobody found it out of the gutters.
That it did.
Hands are where we can see.
Put your hands up.
It'll be funny if nobody was thinking that, but now
they can only think that.
Yeah. Gutters.
Yeah. We're talking about like
Spectral Patrol.
But like,
just have to put that in.
But again, like, that's my thing.
That's really deep. Like,
it's important, man. Like, sometimes we go out too much. Like,
definitely do.
And like, I live alone. Like, I have my own apartment.
Yeah.
And for some reason, I still feel like I don't get much me time.
That's because
I distract myself too. So when I want like actual me time, like when I'm reading, I'm not thinking about myself.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm listening to music, dancing around with my lightsaber. I'm in my virtual reality world.
Dancing around with
that happens.
Can I go to record you one day?
Sure,
I guess I'll pay to watch
that. I practice my kung fu, my sword forms.
Do you, man?
You know, because I keep myself so entertained in this beautiful world that like meditation is the only time when I'm actually reflecting on myself. Mm-hmm. And even meditation is so difficult because half the time I'm still thinking about just the events of the day.
Like Star Wars and all the timelines, yeah.
So you get lost.
Cosplay, yeah. So me time, self-reflection takes effort.
Absolutely,
if you're going out, you get dressed up, you line up your beard, whatever, you get your hair done up. So just when you want me time, you gotta make a sacrifice for that too. You gotta sacrifice the outside world, everyone else.
Yeah.
Like, I can say it this way too, you know, like, doing what I do now, it's like, you know, like, almost always out of the house and stuff. And I wanna change that, really do. Like, cause, you know, sacrificing time and not spending time with family. And I recently started doing that, I would say, like, since last year, Christmas time.
Yo, family first, man.
Like, that's what I started doing. I mean, I was noticing that I was, like, working 2-3 jobs. I went in the morning, came back home late, and, like, I really didn't have time to, like, go to, you know, hang out with family. You know when I felt it? I felt it when my family, they were having dinner, and I came home, and everybody was, like, already getting ready for bed. I was like,
damn.
So I was like, I had to like sit alone and eat at the dining table. I was like, yo, that just feels weird.
So that's when I quit my two jobs,
my morning and my afternoon jobs, so I can like spend that time with my family. And nowadays, like, I, you know, wake up in the early in the morning, I go do my gym thing, and that's when I really started focusing on my gym as well.
Nice.
You know, like, start working out, you know, be
good job,
the person,
man,
that I want to be.
That's good me time.
That's good me time. Like, an hour or two just to myself, do what I want to do, and then, like, you know, drop my brothers and sisters off to school, you know, hang out with mom, do groceries, spend time.
I agree with that.
I definitely agree, you know, like, you should, like, sometimes just
disconnect.
Stop the sacrifices that you're doing. Like, yes, I get it. We all have to sacrifice at some things at some point. Mm. You know, we have to go to work. We have to do things. We have to do bills and all that, right? So, but so the where does it end is like, you know, when it's like really like killing you and like you're not really able to feel something for yourself.
It's so easy to get swept up.
Yes, you know? And it really is.
So days like, become weeks, become years, man.
For me, it was like family time. That's what really like kind of like gave me the shock. I was like, yo, like you gotta do when like you're not really spending time for yourself, like and spending that time and eating at the table. I was like, Jesus, I really am sacrificing a lot, right? Like, cause that time you don't get back, right? Like just sitting down with family and having dinner is like
one of the blessing. It's a blessing, right? Like, you know how lucky we are.
It's a blessing, man. Just like getting to talk to your family, knowing about their day, what's happening, make plans for some other day.
Yeah, man. Everyone, go home and hug your mom and your dad. Yeah, you know,
like, and that's what it is, and that's what I'm trying to do now, right?
And yourself.
And yourself. I do that every single morning in the mirror. Just hug my mirror, man.
Just hug your mirror. Look at this sexy beast.
What's up, handsome? How you doing?
I like this blonde hair.
I do that spells on my mirror, yo.
All right, Sirosh, you're the last one, bro.
Yeah, I think like
I got no comment.
No comment.
But no, sacrifice your time for the good of this podcast.
So yeah, I think that's true.
Yeah, you come for the podcast too.
Yeah, so I think you guys covered mostly all the points and stuff. I just wanted to add, like, you, in terms of sacrificing, you have to know what you're sacrificing for, and you have to make. You have to ask yourself if it is it worth it, you know. So for me, like, I'm not working right now, so I can't relate to those at the moment in my life.
I'm jealous.
But
100%.
But yeah, like in terms, I feel like I do some sacrifices for my family, and I feel like that's all right in a way.
Yeah.
And same vice versa, they do some sacrifices for me as well. So like. There's like a two-way street going on.
That's what knits a family together, is when you're giving for each other, you know?
Mm. Yeah, so so you just gotta, at the end of the day, make sure it's worth it. And if it is, then, you know, keep doing some of the sacrifices that you want.
So here's a good question, and we don't even have to try to answer it because it's way too deep. How do we know when our sacrifices are worth it? You know?
You just do.
Right?
It just feels in your heart. It's cheesy, but it's true.
Take time to listen to that inner voice.
Okay, I have a good way to case that. When you don't have regret, that the time you just waste, the time slot in which you're doing this thing, compared to what you could have been doing, the regret for that.
Yeah.
If it's there, then, you know, maybe it's not worth it. But then if it's not there, then it's like, okay, you know what, maybe this is not...
Very good point.
That can be like the most 100% correct answer, but I feel like that is. And just like adding on to yours, because you talked about family, right? Me, I would always spend time alone, because I came here for university. I spent 4 years alone, and I got used to that. So me spending time with family, I'm always like, you know, I could be doing something better at the time.
Really?
Which is bad. No. But
I can be eating Kraft dinner right now.
Yeah. But that's wrong, right? It's wrong though, right? So now I hard to change myself, I guess. Hard to, you know, like,
now you eat with that stuff, ignoring your family.
Yeah. Well, not now, like a year or like two, yeah. A year or something, right? Yeah. Woo. So like,
yeah, we all get stuck in our ways.
I do feel bad, yeah. So yeah, I mean, it's good, man. Those are some pretty good answers.
And again, right? With great power comes great responsibility.
Mm.
Uncle Ben. With great power comes great sacrifice. Right, just Logan?
Yeah.
Unfortunately, yeah, Logan.
Spoilers, bro.
I'm joking.
But yeah, just...
I didn't mean anything.
Yeah, just to add about on that regret thing. Just regret doing this whole podcast. I could have been eating with my friends right now and chilling, but no.
You know, Sirosh, you always say that after 30 episodes of recording with me, you
31.
Still
managed... This is 31, right? Or 32.
Yeah, yeah. 32. This is 32, but you were not able to come to one of them, so I always go one less.
Oh.
You've only missed one.
I was sick. I could have died that day. Sick of the not show. Really, but I was sick of the show.
It's okay. But yeah. I would have given you a shout out on the show if you died or
whatever. I'm joking. At least I got that.
I'm joking.
At least I got that.
Shots fired.
I want like an in memoriam thing with like all my highlights in the podcast, and that's what I want.
Nah, man.
That's it.
Well, from year one.
Can someone bring up the time turner and undo this?
I don't think I can do the Tricendence podcast with us, Sarosh, like, because he's been there since episode zero, so it's good. Yeah, man.
Shout outs to Sarosh, man. Captain Cloudy.
He's right here.
Yes. More shadows to me.
Threw the camera back to you, man.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for listening. This has been the Tricendence Podcast, where we talked about random stuff such as, can lightsabers cut through adamantium claws?
Yes.
As well as the only future of gaming.
Yes.
Only if it's liquid. And of course, sacrificing.
No.
Well, not for a cult.
Don't do it.
Not for a cult, but like your time, okay? Okay,
oh
your
time.
Never sacrifice for food.
That's a good point.
Food first.
That's okay, so from a cow's perspective.
Food for thought. Food for thought.
Food for thought. There you go.
There we go. See, there we go.
So funny. So funny. Oh.
So funny.
If you want to check us out and our beautiful faces, we are over at youtube.com on the channel Project Pandemonium. That's
how
Panda.
How do you spell Panda?
P-A-N-D-A.
Like
the bear and then monium. And our audio podcasts are available on SoundCloud, iTunes, Google Music. Thank you so much for listening. My name is Aves. To my right is Sarosh.
I don't know.
Okay.
Take care, guys.
I'll do mine in sign language. My name is Kareem. Stay classy, San Diego.
San Diego. This is Canada. And of course, thank you so much to our special guest, the Hobbit, for coming.
With the good hair. Guys. Abed with the good hair.
Yeah, it's with his blonde hair. All right, guys, let's point at the camera and give a thumbs up, because This is a cheesy 80s outro. Take care, guys. Bye.